I wanted to make a quick video on how to separate your notes. I'll put that in quotations because I don't actually believe in real separation in note taking. But I get this question a lot, probably because Reflect lets you create multiple profiles. And so people have this instinct to create a new profile if they have two jobs or a main job and a side project or something like that. But that really takes away a lot of the functionality of note taking. So I'm going to give you some methods so that you don't have to create a different profile, but you still get a little bit of that separation. So I want to start off by just kind of having you ask yourself why you need to separate your notes and then consider, you know, why you shouldn't separate them. So if you think about why you want to separate them, it's probably for, you know, just some sense of organization or cleanliness, whatever. All of those are valid. But there's actually quite a lot of reasons not to separate them. And you should really consider both of those, because I think I used to do a lot of separation in my note taking where I would divide them up. And over time, I've gone more and more into one kind of collective list. So I don't even like to put them in different sections in my notes. But of course, I have notes for dedicated projects. Some of those will have tasks that I want to deal with. So I'll show you that. But I think the first kind of tip I will give for this is just consider that the best option might be doing very minimal separation and actually not really worrying about separating them that much. So the first method I'm going to go show you these on my daily note is nesting bullets within your daily note. So if I go to my daily note and let's pretend that I have my Reflect work, so I can put in Reflect here. And let's say then I also have my agency work. And let's say that I just want to kind of separate those two. So I could literally just start doing my to-dos and my tasks underneath this, and I can start listing them. I'll just kind of put some fake ones in here, and maybe I also want to check email on that one. So I think that's actually a pretty good example. It's like, you know, you need to do email, but those are going to be separate tasks. So you could just separate them like this, and maybe there's like a client call or something like that. And that actually works pretty well. And then you can just kind of keep these clean and separate. You know which one is associated with each. And I can even, you know, click on these backlinks and then see those lists show up. And actually, if I go out back out of focus, well, first, let me actually just kind of, let's say the client call, we want to change that one to a task. So that just changed to a circle there, you see. And now if I exit focus mode and here in my tasks tab, then I see that this will then fall in my task tab. So then I know it's under there. And it also retains that startup cookie label because it was underneath that list, which is really, really nice for organizing your tasks and to-do lists. Now, alternatively, just to kind of show you, I don't do such a separation anymore. I just have one master list. So if I was taking that email list, for example, I might say one checklist is check email for, and then I would put Reflect right there. And I would say check email for startup cookie. And then I only have one list, and I think that's much easier, and then it's only related to that. But there is a difference there. So if I change both of these, whoops, wrong shortcut. If I change both of these into tasks, they will both still show up there, but there's not that little label. I think it's better because the backlink's in here directly. So if I want to, I can just click on Reflect directly, and it takes me to that note, which is really, really nice. So again, I am a favor of the master list here. I just want to give it to you as that option. Okay, so I covered nesting the under bullets in your note like that in the daily note. Let me cover having project pages. And this is something that I do. So let's say I have a new side project called, I'm just going to call it Side Project Sam. And let's say I need to add in an initial task, and I'm going to say, what would be like do by domain? I don't know. I'm pretending I'm starting a side project here, and then maybe like make landing page, and then share on product hunt. I have no idea. Great. So now I have this side project, and then let's say I'll go to my Reflect note and I can add some tasks there. So here I already have some stuff. So maybe I want to just have a bullet here called tasks, and then I could put them underneath. And again, it's maybe like do keyword research and then record video. Cool. Okay. So I just wanted to put tasks in a couple notes pretending That these are, well, other than pretending side project, reflect real. So now on my tasks tab, I see, in addition to those ones in the daily note, I now have a reflect note and a side project note, and all of these are under each one. Now that's how I like to outline kind of every project. So I think this is more relevant for an actual side project versus my main job, like reflect. But let's say I've bought the domain and I need to make the landing page next, but I'm like, wow, I'm really busy traveling this week or something, and I'm not gonna get to it till like next week. So I'm gonna make this one due 1 week from now, which is apparently August 22nd, nice. And now that is scheduled and it now comes in upcoming. So that's a really nice system because then I can move them into where I want them in advance and then they'll show up on that day. Also, if I click on this day, now it shows up in my incoming backlinks. And so if I want to, I can move it into my main daily note. Okay, so that was project pages with tasks. Now, you might be wondering about tags. I get this question a lot. I don't really recommend doing tags because you're gonna then have to manually add it to everything. So what I mean by that is if I'm going into Reflect and, you know, it might make sense if I'm going into, say, like Reflect, I could create a tag and then put my tasks under here. That might be what you're tempted to do. And then I would do, you know, the same thing for tag for startup cookie. But really, I'm going to want everything to relate to that. And so I would then have to make sure I add this tag into every other note that has to do with startup cookie or reflect. And so then suddenly you're going to start doing weird things like going into the reflect note and adding in, I guess, a reflect tag to the reflect page. And suddenly you're like, that doesn't really make very much sense, does it? And then also you click on that tag and what you get is just kind of a useless list of like daily notes and other notes and stuff. So I really don't recommend that. Backlinks work way better. Just use reflect as a backlink instead of a tag. So to be honest, that's kind of my advice on tags, is just ignore it. The last thing I want to mention is if you do want to do a method like this in your daily note where you have them separate, you can go into your preferences and templates and create, I could just edit this one, I guess. Maybe you want to like make your main to-do list have different categories. So maybe one category is habits, and then maybe the other one is reflect, and then maybe the other one is startup cookie. And maybe I want to start, the habits are pre-filled. So maybe it's take a walk, meditate, there we go. and then maybe reflect, I don't want anything pre-filled because I'm not sure what my day is gonna look like. So I'm just gonna start with a blank one for these. And then what that now lets me do, if I go back to my daily notes and let's pretend it's now tomorrow, and I can just do slash, type in to do, and that comes nice and pre-filled for me. So if you are someone that likes to separate these in this format, the templates are very, very helpful. But honestly, at the end of the day, I still just recommend combining everything. So I hope that at least helped to figure out what your preference is.